gonna let me grab that. When you need to grunt like that, you ain't even asleep. You're snoring in the chubs. Ugh. I need to check the audio of it.
Okay.
No, that's what I'm saying. Whenever you find it.
Are you streaming now?
Yeah.
It's not popping up. There it is.
5 Hour Energy presents. Why are you so tired?
Can I see everyone? I'm gonna put my headphones. Food coma. So as not to create horrible, horrible echo. Disgusting energy commercials. Shut up. Oh wow, my entire computer has to reset itself now.
But why though?
I don't know.
When you turn it on and it just resets.
Yeah, I turned it on, it's like preparing to configure Windows. Alright, say something now real quick.
Something.
Speak a sentence real quick.
Fucking Peter Piper picked something about pickled peppers.
Okay. Give me just a second, I can hear it. That's interesting.
What?
You can't pause a stream on mobile.
No. You have to just let it go.
It's not.
Yeah.
Welp.
Welp what?
I said welp.
Oh.
You ready?
Start
whenever
you want. Yeah, if you want to start right now.
Yeah.
I know if you wanted to wait on your computer or whatever.
Nah, the only thing the computer would really be used for is checking chat.
Yeah.
Which I'm gonna do once it works. It just says, it keeps saying preparing to configure Windows, do not turn off your computer.
Oh.
So I don't know, I'm gonna tweet it out real quick though. Bloop. Bloop. And then my phone crashes. Why do I have two notifications? Oh shit, my computer actually fucking started.
Amazing!
Okay, are you ready to start?
Yeah, how much of a delay is there?
A few seconds, 10, 15.
Oh, jeez.
Here, I can,
15 seconds is quite a bit.
Watch the screen, because I'll go to, I'll back out and we'll see how long it takes. Okay. But you can just let me know. There are as many matches as there are superstars, and as many stories as there are matches. And now a new page will be written here in the WWE Universe.
Yeah, 15 seconds.
Alright. Could be worse.
Yeah.
Alright then, you ready to begin?
Yeah, let's start.
Let's play some matches. Look at this beginning! Alright. Welcome to Monday Night Raw. with Thorn.
Yeah.
Joining you, I also have two French Bulldogs. They both belong to Thorn, if you can hear them in the background, or one of them. The other is being very good and quiet.
Almost definitely hear Puddin.
Surprisingly enough, I can hear. Anyway, so what we did, I'm just going to summarize it real quick. We put a bunch of wrestlers on Raw, like fucking 102 of them. Every male wrestler in the game. And we put a bunch of created wrestlers with the NXT wrestlers.
Yep.
And that's our Raw on NXT. And we have a few custom championships that we'll discuss if we can do it. Bad News Barrett has one of them.
Yeah.
So we're going to jump in. For these matches, we're going to put momentum at fast. Just to get them go quicker. Why does Raw have 7 matches? This part I'm going to cut out. Because Raw decided it was just going to...
Yeah, number of matches 5.
Okay. Well then. Now I'm leaving it in. Premier Raw is going to have 7 matches since it decided not to update settings and for this Raw.
Yeah.
But anyway, first match is going to be Bad News Barrett versus the Ultimate Warrior.
Maybe it's just not counting the rivalry matches that were there.
I think it just doesn't update the first show that you were on, because it creates the show when you reset the universe, which is really dumb.
Yeah.
But either way, who do you want to win this out of Bad News Barrett and Ultimate Warrior?
Ultimate Warrior.
I'm actually going for Bad News Barrett.
All right.
Bad News Barrett is our RC champion. I am just going to start the match.
Welcome to another.
It's going to be every match is going to be simulated as Wade Barrett immediately kicks Ultimate Warrior in the fucking jaw. We have an RC championship instead of an IC championship because Royal Cola is delicious. And also because Wade Barrett is the recognized character. He gets a fucking recognition for once in his life. Ultimate Warrior kicking Wade Barrett while he's fucking down. I don't know, I'm just not super into the first match. I just want crazy shit to immediately start happening.
Yeah.
We know what happens. We know Universe Mode goes nuts after a little while.
Oh, yeah. It's why he calls it the
Barrett Barrage. Who do you think, if you had to pick someone for Wade Barrett to fight at whatever the hell the first pitch of these streamers is? I mean, he's got incredible
size and strength. But you know what? Barrett just knows how to hurt people and how to win. I'm looking at, I'm like really distracted by Ultimate Warrior's like game model right now. Because we just got done doing character creations.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of looking at this, and this seems a lot sillier than the stuff that was in the creations, and this is like an actual model in the game.
Because they're allowed to do whatever we want. We're limited by their imagination.
How come I couldn't make that lady right there? That lady right there in the
purple. Because you were playing as a guy. You're not gonna lose many matches. Jesus, Wade Barrett. Wade Barrett's trying to fucking kill Ultimate Warrior. We're going to start Universe Mode off with an injury. Put him back in the grave. Wade Barrett, what the hell are you doing? Jesus Christ, Wade Barrett. Smashing Ultimate Warrior into the pole.
Oh my god.
Wade Barrett's going to prove himself as a champion. So, I'm going to say this right now. We can't hear any sound from the game.
I think this is good strategy.
So, if someone starts getting counted out, we have no idea.
Okay.
We don't know what the count number is. So if it just suddenly ends in a DQ, we were very unaware of it. Jubble and Maggle Cole getting out of there. Being very concerned that maybe Ultimate Warrior will end up going through a table.
I think that'd be okay. I wouldn't mind Ultimate Warrior going through the table. First match on Raw.
Yeah. This is a pretty crazy first match, just in terms of the people in it.
Yeah.
Not particularly with what's going in so far, other than Wade Barrett's a fucking monster.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Is this it? Is this it for the Ultimate Warrior? Bad news, Barrett. Nah, he just kind of punched him in the head. I mean, I think this is probably it for the Ultimate Warrior. I think your main man's going down.
Oh, yeah.
I think Wade Barrett... Oh, he's taunting him. Is Wade Barrett going to knock him out on the outside? No, he's going to fucking throw him into the stairs. Wade Barrett has no chill in the beginning of this match. But Ultimate Warrior looking to turn it around.
Just tell me the sound of my computer is in on once I open the stream here. Oh my god, it is. Please, no, don't let go. Let me turn the volume off before it starts.
Exactly like a volume symbol. Ultimate Warrior going up top. Bam! Smashing Wade Barrett's head in, giving him a concussion. King, earlier you mentioned many of bad news. Wade Barrett kicks Ultimate Warrior in his tiny little baby knee. Ready to take him down. as he throws Ultimate Warrior back into the corner. I'm surprised this isn't over yet, honestly.
Oh.
And at fast momentum, I think we're getting to the corner right now. But you know what? Maybe that's just me. Maybe you're hoping for Ultimate Warrior to turn things around.
That's how awesome Barrett's power and mean streak are. Match to be over already. Not too interesting.
You want to move on to the rivalry matches with 7 matches on this Raw? Is Ultimate Warrior already picking him up for a signature?
And now, Ultimate Warrior
already gorilla pressed him. And is it the Warrior Splash? Warrior just ends it out of nowhere. Come on, Wade Barrett. No, don't do it. 1, 2, 3. Wait. Oh, Wade Barrett kicked out at the very end, even though after the 3 count he kicked out.
Yep.
I was like, the hell just happened, Wade Barrett?
Yeah, I was about to say. And here's some highlights
from the matchup. Here's the only replay worthy. So, first match, Universe Mode. Wade Barrett gets a loss. Rip Wade Barrett. So, you must be happy with this outcome.
Yeah.
Ultimate Warrior jumping in already.
Looking like a fucking cartoon over here.
Just like
that
real
PS2
life.
Crowd out there too.
I'm gonna keep track of wins and losses to an extent. I'm gonna keep track of who never wins matches and who never loses matches. Wade Barrett starts off a pretty poor champion to start off Universe Mode with a loss. Ultimate Warrior may be looking to steal that championship from him. Wait, oh my god, I just remembered who our original RC champion was. It was Randy Savage.
Oh!
Welp. Next match. So I actually didn't... We don't know what any of these matches are, aside from Ultimate Warrior and Wade Barrett.
Yeah.
So we're going to jump into the next one. Right, because it didn't update the first show, I took all the divas out.
Yeah.
We're actually going to skip... We're going to skip Nikki Bella versus Emma. Sorry if you wanted to see it. Simulate. Yes, I want to simulate. We'll find out who won here in a little bit. That's, it's frustrating. Next match is a tag team, D-Generation X versus The New Day, DX being our tag team champions in this universe. Absolutely, slaughtering everyone in the, tag team tournament. I don't know why they chose to throw in Xavier Woods with, Kofi Kingston instead of Big E, but maybe Big E was busy. Either way, they're going to have to take on Triple H and Shawn Michaels. Who do you think? Who's your money on? Now, me having watched the tournament, I think DX is about to end lives.
Yeah.
Is that what you think as well?
Yeah, if the New Day wins, I'm going to be very disappointed.
New Day immediately faces DX at the next review. I think this was the first rivalry match as well. I'm probably going to start going back to the match menu before going on to the next match just so we can double check each thing. Hype up whatever's next. I think this might be the first rivalry. Maybe Big E can run in, or will run in as a distraction. I don't know. Meanwhile, Kofi Kingston's doing a pretty good job. What I saw a lot of in the tournament was they would do, or everyone really, would do really well against DX and put up a good fight, get really close to the end, and then DX would just out of nowhere hit like 3 pedigrees and a super kick and win the match. Maybe we'll see that now. Maybe Kofi Kingston's mad. Kofi Kingston wants his title back. Xavier Woods there. Has Triple H really gotten, like, Triple H got like 3 moves in so far, hasn't he?
He just got laid out.
Kofi Kingston tagging in Xavier Woods. I've never seen Xavier Woods wrestle in this game. It's always been Big E. Can he take out Triple H as he throws Triple H into the ropes and clotheslines him? If they can just beat the crap out of Triple H now, they'll never have to tag in Shawn Michaels, and then Shawn Michaels just won't be in the match. He'll just sit there. It'll be a 2-on-1 beatdown. Shawn Michaels clapping for more support. His support means nothing to Triple H. As we all know, Triple H once hit Shawn Michaels with a fucking car. But that's okay. Triple H making a comeback against Xavier Woods. Probably going to go for that tag as he's probably tired. Yep, here comes Shawn Michaels. Probably going to hit 3 sweet chin musics out of nowhere. Xavier Woods backing off for a second. Should have just ran for the tag, but instead now he's getting thrown to the outside. Triple H is walking up to him. This is where it really turns into a 2-on-1 beatdown. Oh, Jesus. Everyone better get out. That guy's freaking out in the corner.
I'm not sure I can watch this.
Xavier Woods pushing. It's just everyone thrown into the Raw. Where are you at? Where's Kofi Kingston at? He's just like waiting patiently as they sit on the other side. Xavier Woods attacking Triple H, not the smartest move since Shawn Michaels is the legal man. Both Shawn Michaels and Xavier Woods could be counted out. could come pretty close. I'm not going to count. I mean, a DQ is a loss, but, like, in terms of undefeated streaks, I'm not going to count DQs as a loss. If Xavier Woods gets DQ'd here, I'll just be like, oh, he hasn't won a match. Ever. Like, for some reason, I thought Xavier Woods was about to tag in Triple H, but that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Xavier Woods wrenching the head of Shawn Michaels.
Don't expect a lot of mercy to be shown
but
here.
What will it do?
None expected and none will be shown.
As they throw, I'm like watching the screen to make sure it's working fine.
It's like clear.
Is it?
Nice fist drop.
Okay, that's fantastic. It's my computer then. I'm glad. It looks really amazing. Yours is way better. Look at my screen on the computer.
Yours is like, yours is behind.
Yeah, I know. My laptop's not
way
great.
Way behind.
My laptop's not great. I'm glad you have it on the phone right there to work out just fine and dandy. Kofi Kingston being tagged back in on Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels going tagging Triple H. Nope, faked him out. Kofi Kingston faked him out. Everyone getting faked out. Leg sweep. Like Kofi Kingston. Could this be it for Shawn Michaels? Could this be the end? I think this was set to normal momentum, so this might end up being a little longer. I don't know for sure. I don't know if it automatically sets the quick. All the more reason to go back to the match menu. As we learned from our first Raw, which is seven matches for no reason. Most Raws will be five matches. This one's going to be at least six, maybe five, if there's a second Divas match.
Yeah.
And there's the tag.
As Triple H gets tagged back in, going back into the two guys who started the match, you think we'll be seeing a finisher anytime soon?
Hopefully.
From this position, and believe me, I'm glad it's fit from this
Triple
position.
Triple H pick him up, and the big knee by Triple H. Taking Kofi Kingston down to the ground. This might be it. Could pick him up for the pedigree. No, he's gonna break Kofi Kingston's leg. Can't jump up, do any of that fancy shit. Triple H gonna feed Kofi Kingston a big old box of booty-os. But Kofi Kingston having none of it, picking up side suplex to Triple H.
He's endured heavy blows here.
For the pin, could this be it? One, two. No, Triple H kicks out right before the three. I kind of almost thought it was it for a second there. As Kofi Kingston tags in Xavier Woods. Triple H ain't backing out. He's ready for Xavier. He's going to take him on. Hit him with a pedigree right away. Taking him to the middle of the ring. Raking the eyes. Ref just stares on like, oh, I guess I got to let him do that. He's the boss. And then a big DDT by Triple H onto Xavier Woods. Going for the pin. One, two. Xavier Woods kicking out immediately after two. Not quite ready yet. As big of a DDT as that was. Just a backbreaker by Triple H. I thought it was a side suplex in there. Or a side slam. What is Triple H doing? Kofi Kingston sticking up. I have no... Okay, I thought I couldn't tell Xavier Woods reversed there or something. Got his knees up. Triple H picking up Xavier Woods. Xavier Woods reversing it. Knocking him back down. This could be Xavier Woods' chance for the pin. One. Two. Nowhere near enough. That slight shoulder tackle was not enough to take down Triple H. But Xavier Woods grabs him. He's taking him to the ropes. Could be planning a tag team maneuver. Kofi Kingston tags himself in. As they both grab him, what are they doing? Oh, and a kick to the back of the head by Triple H. That might be it for Triple H.
If you want to see an incredible kick that comes...
Roll him over. He's dead weight. One. Two. No. Triple H kicking out from the kick to the back of the head. Kofi Kingston punches him, drop kicks. New Day really taking control here.
WWE locker room here.
Oh, but out of nowhere. Oh, but Kofi Kingston reverses it into a pin. I thought it was a DDT. Xavier Woods going to shop Shawn Michaels, but Triple H kicks out. Shawn Michaels starting to get paranoid. This might be it for Triple H. Triple H must be running out of energy. Xavier Woods threatening Shawn Michaels in the double A spine buster to Kofi Kingston out of nowhere. Triple H calling for the pedigree. Could this be it already? Just out of nowhere once again.
Oh my God.
Does he got it? He gets Kofi Kingston.
Michael.
And he hits Kofi Kingston with the pedigree.
That's it.
He's going for the pin. Shawn Michaels is going to have to stop Xavier Woods if Triple H wants to get this pin. One. Xavier Woods is even going to try to stop it. And Kofi Kingston kicks out of the pedigree just before the three count. As Triple H throws him back down and tags in Shawn Michaels, who's no doubt waiting for that super kick. I told you, out of nowhere, just hitting finishers. Could Shawn Michaels be setting up for a superplex here? Throwing Kofi Kingston hard.
happen next?
We've got him. Superplex and a superplex to Kofi Kingston from Shawn Michaels. Going for the pin. One. Xavier Woods running in, but Triple H stopping him. Xavier Woods kicks out. I couldn't tell if Triple H DDT'd or suplexed Xavier Woods. Shawn Michaels kicking. Oh, Triple H throwing Xavier Woods out as Shawn Michaels drops the elbow on Kofi Kingston. This could be Shawn Michaels' chance while Xavier Woods is down. What's Shawn Michaels doing? Picking him up for a powerbomb? No, a pile driver! Oh, broken neck to Kofi Kingston after taking the pedigree as well. Shawn Michaels going up top, going to drop the elbow, but Xavier Woods is there and throws him down on top of Kofi Kingston. Shawn Michaels might need to set up sweet chin music instead of that elbow drop. He's picking up Kofi Kingston. What's he planning? As he kicks him in the DDT to Kofi Kingston. I keep almost calling him something else. He's going for the top rope again, this time away from Xavier Woods. Smart move. Shawn Michaels going to hit the elbow. Shawn Michaels, oh, but Kofi Kingston reverses into a trouble in paradise. Plus Shawn Michaels open, goes for the pin. One, two. No, Shawn Michaels kicks out, busted open, trouble in paradise, but still kicks out as Kofi Kingston tags in Xavier Woods. That was amazing. Shawn Michaels grabbing Xavier Woods, though, dropping him with a backbreaker. Picking him up, could he be going for the super kick finally? Throwing him into the corner, maybe a tag team finisher with Triple H. Tags in Triple H, they're going for some kind of move here. Oh, and a super kick from Triple H, and the pedigree from Shawn Michaels onto Xavier Woods. But Kofi Kingston running in, he's going to break up the pin. Shawn Michaels jumps again, one, two. Oh, but Kofi Kingston breaks it up. That could have been it for Xavier Woods as Shawn Michaels throws Kofi Kingston out.
And there's the count.
Triple H stomping on Xavier Woods. This is bad. They should have pinned Shawn Michaels while they had the chance. But Xavier Woods reverses Triple H outside the ring, or outside the ropes, and just stare him down. Oh, but Triple H punches him during the stare down. A surprisingly intense match, much better than the first match. Reverse DDT. Xavier Woods going for the pin. Shawn Michaels breaking it up. Kofi Kingston didn't think it was it, didn't feel the need to break it up. You still think DX has this?
Oh, I don't know anymore. This has gone both ways so far.
I can't believe that trouble in paradise on Shawn Michaels. You know, Shawn Michaels exhausted, busted open. His puddin' licks my elbow. But let me tell you something. Puddin' licked my elbow when I wasn't paying attention, and I still felt it. Triple H trying to put Kofi in the corner. Gets him over to his side of the ring, but not in the corner. As Kofi Kingston throws Triple H into that corner, what's Kofi Kingston planning? Putting him up on the top of the rope. Puddin', who do you think's gonna win? We've seen a giant side suplex from the top.
These guys are getting
down goes Triple H, but that hurt Kofi Kingston just as much. Kofi Kingston going for the pin now. No, he's not. He's going up top. What's Kofi Kingston planning here? And an elbow drop taunting Shawn Michaels. One, two, but Triple H still kicks out. What is Kofi? The crowd's going fucking nuts. This is a very intense rivalry match here. As Triple H grabs him. Oh, but Kofi Kingston reverses. Punching Triple H. The disrespect. A slap. A big chop. Oh, but Triple H throws Kofi Kingston down. Triple H grabbing him. I thought he was going for a pin, which wouldn't have been the best idea since Shawn Michaels is probably so tired. And a huge suplex to Kofi Kingston. Now Triple H tagging out the bloodied Shawn Michaels. I don't know what they're playing here. Kofi Kingston crawling needs to get that pin. Dodges out of the way of Shawn Michaels, but Shawn Michaels still grabs him the second time. Picks him up, drops him with the side suplex again. Back over in their corner, which isn't good for Kofi Kingston. As he picks him up, starts wailing on Kofi Kingston. Just beating the crap out of him. Picking him up. Turning Kofi Kingston around. Grabbing him and dropping him hard. What are they going to do? What's Shawn Michaels planning? Oh, and the elbow to Kofi Kingston. As he drags Kofi Kingston to the middle of the ring. Is he going for the pin? Is he going for something else? I think he's going for the sharpshooter, maybe.
Uh-oh, look at this.
And he is. Shawn Michaels locking in the sharpshooter, trying to make Kofi Kingston tap out. Triple H needs to stop Xavier Woods, and he does with the spinning neckbreaker. Kofi Kingston trying to get to the ropes, though. Can Kofi Kingston make it?
Wait a minute.
No, Kofi Kingston gets out of it and kicks out, which is doing to Xavier
Woods. Broke his neck. He killed him.
Xavier Woods might be dead now as Kofi Kingston gets Shawn Michaels into the corner, picking him up, putting him down, hanging him in the tree of woe.
Wearing down the
misses the kick. Starts stomping Shawn Michaels, trying to open up that wound even more. Move the mic closer. Tagging in Xavier Woods, even after the damage done to Triple H, Xavier is still the fresh man. Needs to not let Shawn Michaels tag to Triple H. Shawn Michaels might be getting a tagging move in with Triple H, though, and they do, they tag. Could this be a finishing move? Doesn't look like it. Oh, and they snap the wrist of Xavier Woods as Triple H punches him, picks him up for a side slam.
Talk about getting momentum behind
and stares at him. The intimidation, stomping on Xavier Woods.
How do you stand after an attack like this?
Triple H snapping his neck again. Killing him. Rest in pepperoni, Xavier Woods. As he gets thrown back down, this already insanely long match in the middle. Punching Xavier Woods, backs out, grabs him. What's he going for here? Going for a spinning suplex. Fisherman suplex, I don't know what that's called. Some kind of suplex. Oh, Xavier Woods getting fancy with the punches. Oh, doing the almost splits and taking him down with the punch. Could that be it for Triple H? Will the punches do it? One, two, three, and the punches take down Triple H as Shawn Michaels takes out Kofi Kingston. The New Day getting a win over the tag team champions DX. Quite a match indeed. As we see all the things that happen here, the DDT from Shawn Michaels, the suplex in to the punches. Xavier Woods getting the win. Surprising. I said he probably shouldn't be in here. Thought Big E should be instead. But apparently Xavier Woods is a good member to have. As the New Day celebrates. Oh, New Day got busted open. I don't know how. He kicked Shawn Michaels in the head. Guess he just busted himself open on the way down. Either way, the New Day, all your winners, getting a win over the tag team championships. Maybe that wins them a shot at the tag titles at Extreme Rules. Who knows? DX losing their first ever match here. New Day going 1-0. I put Boudet, I don't care. It doesn't matter on this little notes I'm taking. Alright. So next up, we have another tag team match. This is the rivalry match. That wasn't even the rivalry match. Our next match, which is the rivalry match, is Titus O'Neil and Darren Young, the Primetime Players, versus Kalisto and Sin Cara. Amazing. But, you know, maybe the rivalries will change once it comes time to the next Monday Night Raw, once all our settings have been saved. Maybe we'll get Primetime Players versus the Lucha Dragons. Oh, something going down. They're shaking hands. Sin Cara and Darren Young, they're playing fair. These are both two good guys. All right, they decided to treat this as good sports. Where the hell? Oh, there's Titus O'Neil. I didn't see him there for a second. I was looking at the other side. As Sin Cara immediately runs in, spins him around, takes him down with the arm drag. Who do you got here? Sin Cara or Darren Young? I mean, Lucha Dragons or Primetime Players?
I'm going to go with the Lucha Dragons on this one.
I got to go Lucha Dragons as well. As he DDTs Darren Young. They're both showing good signs of support. They're showing that they're good with each other. I don't know about Titus O'Neil and Kalisto, but clearly Sin Cara and Darren Young respect each other. These two legitimate wrestlers for the match. Very tag team oriented Raw. As we get a leg drop onto Sin Cara, Darren Young not wanting to hold anything back. Wanting to take down good. Going for the pin already. One, two. Sin Cara kicking out just after two already, surprisingly. Darren Young slamming his elbow down. They're trying to fight for who's the best. Darren Young, is Darren Young already calling for a signature? Is this already about to end? As Darren Young picks him up. And the gut buster from Darren Young already, like a minute into the match. One,
millions of dollars.
Two! Oh, but Sin Cara still kicks out. That was Darren Young's finisher. This quickly in as he grabs him. Russian leg sweep to Sin Cara. Not doing so good. Primetime players maybe trying to prove they're also a good tag team wanting to fight DX for the titles.
Uh-oh,
trying to make Sin Cara tap out, trying to choke him out. Sin Cara reverses. This is Sin Cara's chance for some offense and going for a roll-up. No, picking him up, power bombing him. The thing we see Roman Reigns there do all the time. Sin Cara copying it. The pure raw strength, as we all know, of Sin Cara. One, two. Oh, I thought Darren Young was done there for a minute. I thought that was it for Darren Young. As he grabs him, and oh no, Darren Young fights his way out of the legs. What to expect. I think both these men need to tag out. Darren Young going for the tag. Sin Cara not going to let him as he flips him. Thought he was going to go for the pin there, but no. Sin Cara looking down judgmentally, going for the tag on Kalisto. Needs to stop Darren Young from tagging. Kalisto in. Got to go stop him. But Darren Young stops him with another Russian leg sweep. This is going to give Darren Young the chance to tag out to Titus O'Neil. And he is going to do it. He was contemplating staying in and attacking. Titus O'Neil comes in against Kalisto. What is Titus O'Neil going to do? He's going to grab him and immediately put him up to the ropes. What is Titus O'Neil planning? Throwing the ropes and just slam! Fallaway slam. Scoop slam, I don't know. Punching Kalisto's back. Both these two freshmen, and as picks him up, side suplex Kalisto. Kalisto hasn't gotten any offense on Titus O'Neil, just stomping him down. So we're this far in. Do you have any idea who you think is going to win it now? Or do you think it's still pretty even?
I think it's still pretty even.
Slaps him. Is there anyone you particularly want to win? Lucha Dragons?
No.
Oh, Primetime Players?
No.
You don't care?
Neither. I don't care about either of these teams.
Kalisto tagging in Sin Cara. Titus O'Neil staying in, though. Maybe going to do something. Sin Cara grabbing Titus O'Neil. Taking him over to this corner over here. What's he planning? As he hangs him up in the Tree of Woe, going to stomp a mud hole.
Picks him up like a pillow to do it.
PTP, Sin Cara grabs him, puts him up, power bombs Titus O'Neil. Sin Cara busting out all his pure raw aggression in this match. Sin Cara, world-renowned weightlifter, known for his huge muscles and powerful moveset. As he rolls Titus O'Neil over. Titus O'Neil getting up. Sin Cara goes for the punch. Titus O'Neil counters, but Sin Cara grabs him yet again as he picks him up. The Hurricane Rana. What is Sin Cara going to do? He's going to tag out to the Kalisto. Kalisto coming back out on Titus O'Neil. Titus O'Neil's going to be getting tired. Got to take some damage. Oh, and a spinning drop kick to Titus O'Neil. As he goes, what's Kalisto planning? Running over Titus O'Neil, and the big splash to Titus.
My God, his body's been through.
Is Kalisto going to pin? No, Kalisto's not going to pin. He's going to wait for Titus O'Neil to get up on his own. What's he planning here? Oh, and he punches Titus O'Neil. He was planning a big punch, but Titus O'Neil picks him up, and Kalisto reverses it, slamming him down. Now Kalisto's picking up Titus O'Neil. Kalisto is getting and going for the roll up. No! Oh, and the kick! I didn't know what was going on there. Now he's going for the pin, thinking he's knocked out Titus O'Neil. Is this it? One, two, but Titus O'Neil kicks out. Doesn't know where he is, but manages to kick out of the pin. Kalisto stares at him in anger. Could the respect be fading as Titus O'Neil picks him up and slams him down? Going and tagging in Darren Young. Only the second time Darren Young's been in this match. Titus O'Neil's been really tanking the hits. Darren Young picks him up, slams Kalisto down.
My God, his body's been through hell.
Mr. No Days Off, Darren Young. Man, I hope we can get a planning something here. Oh, and a kick to the head.
Ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Wow, look, I don't know. Is Darren Young going to go off for the pin off of that kick? Or is he going to go for the gut buster? He's dragging him to the dead center of the ring. Oh, and the leg drop to Kalisto. And the elbow drop as well. And a bigger elbow drop to Kalisto. Going for the pin. One, two. Oh, but Kalisto kicks out at the three. Almost done. Darren Young, PTP, almost had it on the Lucha Dragons. As Kalisto grabs him, throws him into the corner. What's he planning here? Maybe a tag team move with Sin Cara. What kind of fancy shenanigans are they doing? We see the roll-up picking him up. Oh, and the spit bomb. As Sin Cara goes for the pin. One, two, but Titus O'Neil breaks it up. Kalisto very frustrated with this turn of events, threatening Titus O'Neil. Oh, and grabbing him. Sunset flip powerbomb to Titus O'Neil as we see Sin Cara DDT Darren Young in the inside. Titus O'Neil taking revenge on Kalisto for that powerbomb as Sin Cara picks him up and drops him down. Crowd going wild. Could this be it for Darren Young? One. Oh, but Darren Young grabs the ropes to break the pin. Sin Cara could have had it there, but Darren Young grabs the ropes as he picks Darren Young back up once again. What's he going to do here? Throwing him into the corner. Sin Cara, what are you planning? What are you going to do, Sin Cara? Oh, and the Hurricane Rana. That's got to be it for Darren Young. What is Titus O'Neil doing on the outside? And a power bomb on the outside to Kalisto. Sin Cara slowly striding over. Darren Young throwing him back into the corner. What's Darren Young doing? Oh! Oh, and a leg drop as Titus O'Neil makes his way back up. Darren Young picking up Sin Cara. Kalisto makes his way back to his corner of the ring. Darren Young going for a tag team move with Titus O'Neil. I don't know if this is a finisher or not. What is Titus O'Neil planning? Jesus, Titus O'Neil taking down. That's got to be it for Sin Cara. Darren Young getting back in. Kalisto breaking up the pin just before the three count as Titus O'Neil stomps him. Oh, and Darren Young throws Kalisto back out. Titus O'Neil, don't do it. No! His tummy. Why, Sin Cara? Titus O'Neil could be looking. God, that's gotta hurt. What is this? The ghetto blaster. Oh! As Darren Young throws Kalisto back into the ring as he gets up. One, two. Oh, but Kalisto breaks it up again. A foolish move, and Kalisto slides out of there as Darren Young goes back over. Titus O'Neil decimating Sin Cara, wiping the sweat off his brow, calling for Clash of the Titus. This could be it for Sin Cara, if Darren Young can take care of it. No! I don't know if this is Clash of Titans. I don't know if this is. This is the Ghetto Blaster. I don't know. Oh, and Titus O'Neil, whatever it was, takes him down. Going for the pin. One, two, three! As Darren Young DDTs Kalisto. Primetime players defeat the Lucha Dragons. In a very long and hard-fought match, we have PTP. Going over the Lucha Dreams. So how do you feel about the outcome of that match?
Maybe it was a very impressive match.
Primetime players earned a match against the New Day, maybe for number one contendership. Possibly, I don't know. Look at him keeping that pin hand strong. Titus O'Neil. Oh, make money every day. Billions of dollars. Primetime players. Make money.
Big money.
So now we're moving on to match number four of the match. Actions speak louder than words. Tough competition. The tag team competition begins to heat up as Darren Young and Titus O'Neil take on Sin Cara and Kalisto. We get that little rivalry wrap up there. 4 weeks away from Extreme Rules, ex-John Cena, our WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Moving on to the fourth match of this very long-running Monday Night Raw. Lots of tag matches means lots of time spent doing stuff. As we go into match number five, a triple threat, Randy Orton, Mark Henry, and Adrian Neville. Who are you going to call for this match? Randy Orton, actually, our big pimpin' champion, meaning he gets to be in the tag team faction with me and Thorn as the pimpin' strongs. Who do you think is going to win this match? I have to root for our boy Randy Orton.
I know Randy Orton over here is going to have a good chance, but I got to root for the underdog here. I'm going to call for Neville.
I was not even to say the underdog, Mark Henry. So, Adrian Neville taking on, Randy Orton and Adrian Neville teaming up against Mark Henry. As Randy Orton grabs Adrian Neville, these alliances don't last long in the triple threat match, especially when you're in the ring with a sneaky snake like Randy Orton.
Snicking around.
The legend killer, Randy Orton, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, almost called him Schmark Henry, and the man gravity forgot, Adrian Neville. We've got the snake, the big man, and Neville, all
the elf. We got an elf. A
small, medium, and large in this triple threat match on our very first Monday Night Raw. As they throw Randy Orton out of the ring. Oh, but Adrian Neville jumps down. Mark Henry looks confused and lost.
Mark Henry forgetting what he's doing here.
They're taking down Randy Orton, maybe hoping that whoever pins Randy Orton gets a shot at this big pimpin' championship. Mark Henry and Adrian Neville, neither of which are in an actual tag team on their own. Mark Henry taking Neville into the ring. Oh, and Randy Orton sneaking up on Mark Henry, but not doing anything.
Not doing anything with it.
Oh, but they're teaming up as the double DDT to Adrian Neville. They're teaming up on him now, taking down the underdog, the little guy. Adrian Neville takes him down. Drop kicks Mark Henry. Adrian Neville.
Adrian Neville just not
it's
letting
anyone's
up on
game.
Mark Henry.
Adrian Neville knows Mark Henry is a big threat, a big man with the Hurricane Rana, but he can't forget Randy Orton is the champion, proving himself strong. Randy strong. But they both, Neville and Mark Henry, have to be careful as that RKO can come literally from out of nowhere. As Mark Henry reverses into the leg sweep on Randy Orton, Neville grabbing him. Oh, but Mark Henry says, no, bitch, no. Oh, and the drop kick, but Mark Henry stays on his feet, and another drop kick takes Mark Henry down. Neville shouting in the face of Mark Henry as Randy Orton picks him up. Neville grabbing him. Randy Orton. Oh, but he can't pick up Mark Henry, and it leads into a suplex from Mark Henry. As Neville grabs him, into like a mini RKO from Randy. Almost called him Randy Neville. Adrian Neville. So much action to call in this triple threat match. As we got, almost called him Mr. T.
Mr. T still looks lost in the ring.
Mark Henry going smudge walks from the bedroom into the recording area and then walks down the stairs. Probably for some edible cat food. Randy Orton going for the pin right in front of Mark Henry. Mark Henry like, hell no. Slamming down. Oh, he kicks Mark Henry in the dick and slams him down.
Mark Henry leaving
in the spin. Mark Henry grabbing a steel chair. Coming in, no DQ in a triple threat match. As we see, Neville going for the pin. Mark Henry slamming down the chair on Randy Orton. Oh, and on to Adrian Neville. And another one. Oh, but Randy Orton's getting pumped up as he picks up Adrian Neville. Oh, and he takes him down. Randy Orton going for his comeback. Hits Mark Henry with the backlash. Mark Henry's like, my wrist.
You broke my hand.
We see Randy Orton taking out the knee of Adrian Neville.
Destroying Neville's knee.
It's hard to jump off ropes when you ain't got no legs. Randy Orton rolling him over. Calling for it. Could be calling for the RKO. No. Stomping on him. What's Randy Orton going to do here? Oh, and the high knee drop. What's Randy Orton going for? Oh, Mark Henry grabs him, slams him down. Oh, and tackles him. We're seeing all kinds of moves. Maybe going for the pin, but he's got to take care of Adrian Neville first. No, doesn't realize Neville's up as Neville breaks up the pin on Randy Orton. Neville going to punch Mark Henry. Instead, mini RKO once again. As we see Randy Orton take Mark Henry and then goes for the pin, ignoring Neville. Disrespect. Neville just sitting there, no, but decides to break it up. Maybe contemplating if it was worth it. Oh, Neville picks up Randy Orton, power bombs him. As we see him go, possibly for the pin once again. No, could Neville be setting up for the red arrow? Going to the top rope as Mark Henry stands there. Mark Henry punches him down. Puts him up. Good Mark Henry superplex Neville onto Randy Orton. No, picking him up. And a huge toss. That's gotta hurt for Neville. As, goes to grab Randy Orton but fails. And the drop kick to the head of Mark Henry. Randy Orton dragging Mark Henry to the middle of the ring. That's still chair still in play. Kicking every limb of Mark Henry. Randy Orton just wanting to inflict pain onto him.
That's it. He's done.
Hitting him hard. And Neville goes for the pin. Randy Orton breaks it up. Very angry about the things going on. Punches Adrian Neville. Picking him up. Going into the exploder suplex. But he needs to deal with Mark Henry first, which he does as he slaps him down. Going for the pin as Neville gets up. One, two, three. No, but Mark Henry kicks out of the slap. Oh, Neville misses the spinning drop kick as Randy Orton drops a big elbow on Mark Henry. What is Neville planning? Randy Orton doesn't see Neville up from behind.
And
Neville!
Snicky to snake.
Oh, and that 450 splash onto Mark Henry as Neville goes for the pin. But Randy Orton immediately breaks it up. Doesn't want his first match to be a loss. As we see Neville picking up Mark Henry. Putting him down. Elbowing him in the head. Lots of long matches here on Monday Night Raw. A test of endurance. Really putting these wrestlers to the test as Mark Henry crawls for the ropes. Adrian Neville putting Randy Orton up on the top rope. What could he be planning here? Possibly a Hurricane Rana. And it is a Hurricane Rana to Randy Orton. As we see Mark Henry planning something with Randy Orton. But no, Neville stops him. Once, none of it. Oh, but Mark Henry reverses real quick. And headbutts Neville to the ground, kicking Randy Orton. Mark Henry, oh, but Randy Orton reverses this, tossing Mark Henry over his shoulder like a rag doll. What's Randy Orton planning here? Oh, and kicking all the limbs of Mark Henry once again.
While Neville watches in confusion.
Neville still trying to collect his gathering. Oh, but sneaks up mini RKO to Randy Orton from Neville. The NKO. As he turns him around. Oh! What a painful looking Hurricane Rana. As we see Neville doing something, planning for something else. Drop kicking Randy Orton to the head as Mark Henry sneaks up from behind. Into the side, suplex. Everyone's down. This could be Mark Henry's chance. Mark Henry picking up Adrian Neville. And going for the big slam. The crowd goes wild. And the headbutt. Randy Orton grabbing Mark Henry from behind. Someone needs to end this fast. Randy Orton's calling for it. He's calling for it on Mark Henry while Neville lays on the ground. And an RKO to Mark Henry. Going for the pin. Neville still down. One, two, three. Oh, Neville barely breaks it up. As he kicks Mark Henry back to the ground, Neville grabbing Randy Orton and dropping him with a side suplex. Neville going up top for the red arrow on Randy Orton. Is he going to do it? Oh, Randy Orton RKO out of nowhere. As Mark Henry gets back up and drags Neville for the pin. Randy Orton sits there and Randy Orton breaks it up. Catching that red arrow with the RKO really threw Randy off as Mark Henry grabs him and slams him down with the backbreaker. Neville going for the legs of Randy Orton, DDTing the leg of Randy Orton as Mark Henry grabs him, but Neville fights out. Neville running up. Oh, but Mark Henry punches him in a big clothesline. That forearm taking down Neville. Oh, no. Mark Henry kicking the chest hard of Neville. Oh, but it appears Mark Henry's out of stamina, and Randy Orton takes advantage of that. Grabbing Mark Henry from behind and punching him in the back of the head. Mark Henry's exhausted as Randy Orton grabs a chair. Neville tries to steal the pin. And he breaks the three. Breaks it up with the steel chair. Who's he gonna turn the chair on first? It's Neville! Taking down Neville with a steel chair. And another shot. And another. Killing Adrian Neville. But Neville gets back up. Goes to slam Mark Henry. But Mark Henry says no. Randy puts down the chair. Mark Henry throwing Randy Orton to the ropes. Decides it's smarter to maybe pin Neville instead. No, gonna hurt the knee of Neville. As Randy Orton picks him up, the little guy, into the ring, going for the DDT. There it is, vintage Randy Orton busting open Neville with the DDT. As Mark Henry punches Randy Orton and headbutts him down. Going, picking him up. Could we see a world's strongest slam here? No, but a slam onto the steel chair and the headbutt, the third one this match. I think Mark Henry could pin him when he wants, and he's pinning Randy Orton. Could this be at one, two, three, and Mark Henry pins the Big Pimpin' Championship for a win. Amazing match. Went on forever. Would have been fun for the main event, but instead, we've got another match to go. Great match, great showing by everyone. Mark Henry 1-0, starting Raw. Randy Orton, despite being a champion, is now 0-1. Not looking good for his Big Pimpin' Championship. As Mark Henry brushes off the ref, showing that he is the dominant force in the WWE. And now, for our main event of Raw. A longer Raw than usual. Our main event is a rivalry match, but who will it be between? Maybe John Cena, as he's the World Heavyweight Champion. But it will be. Why are there two more matches? John Cena versus Ryback. There are. No, there's seven matches. Okay, that was match number five. I thought that was match number six. We've got John Cena versus Ryback. Fast momentum. John Cena being the World Heavyweight Champion. Going up against Ryback, the big guy. Ryback maybe trying to go for that World Heavyweight Championship. Smudge entering in to root for someone. Do you root for John Cena, or do you root for Ryback Smudge? Who you root for? Oh, he leave. As we begin our match, who do you think's going to win? Who do you want to win as they lock up, push each other into the ropes?
I can see our current champion winning this.
I got to go for John Cena, the current champion. Always winning lots of matches. The referee telling Ryback to back off. Ryback starting to fight dirty. John Cena now pushing Ryback into the corner. As we see Ryback laying there. Oh, Ryback slaps him. Ryback fighting dirty. John Cena pissed off. Oh, and they lock up once again. Ryback getting advantage of the lockup. John Cena turning it around, though, into his advantage and taking Ryback down. What is John Cena planning here? A punch to the head. That's what he's planning. As he throws Ryback into the ropes. Oh, and the Hurricane Rana to Ryback.
Picking this guy in the back trying to take a picture.
He wants a picture of Ryback versus John Cena here at the great first Monday Night Raw, and a big splash from Ryback as Smudge waddles off.
Like, the crowd is very unenthusiastic.
Ryback, and they're like, whoa, I thought they were doing the wave there for a second. As Ryback punches John Cena in the corner, but John Cena reverses. And the big Russian leg sweep to Ryback. John Cena getting kicked back right by Ryback. Kicking John Cena while he's down. Silly Ryback. Silly Willy Ryback. But John Cena reverses. Very even match. Both of us thinking John Cena's got this, but we have to admit, Ryback is the big guy. If there's anyone who can beat John Cena, it's this walking mass of muscle. John Cena, German suplex to Ryback, trying to break his spine. as we see John Cena punch him down, pick him up. Good thing about these one-on-one matches is once a finisher is hit, there's a good chance it's over. As we see a DDT to Ryback. No interruptions, and if there is, it's probably a DQ. John Cena going for the five-knuckle shuffle right off the bat. This could be it. You can't see John Cena. Ryback could be in trouble here. And the five-knuckle shuffle connects on Ryback. Could that be it? John Cena goes for the pin. One, two. But Ryback kicks out right after two. John Cena can't believe Ryback kicks out of the five-knuckle shuffle as Ryback goes to turn around. And John Cena... No, Ryback picks up John Cena. But John Cena fights his way out. John Cena now. No, Ryback ping him again. John Cena taking too long. The snapmare by Ryback into a headlock. Trying to wear down John Cena. Will John Cena tap out?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
John Cena fights out of Ryback's headlock, knocking him down. As we see Ryback immediately with the elbow. Ryback not happy after that five-knuckle shuffle. And the big punch to John Cena, getting his head caught in the ropes. As Ryback takes him down once again. Ryback kicking him hard, kicking him once again. John Cena needs to mount some offense. And a belly-to-belly suplex to John Cena. Ryback's taking huge control of this match. As we see him punch John Cena. Picking up. It's slamming him down. This fucking Raw is going to like at least half an hour now. With another match to go. As he picks him up, bench pressing John Cena and the Gorilla Press to John Cena. Ryback calling for it. Feed me more. Calling for the shell shock to John Cena. No, he was going for the meat hook clothesline. But John Cena reverses, pulling him, rolling him over. John Cena really showing Ryback what for. As he taunts Ryback, grabs him, picks him up into a slam. And we see another five-knuckle shuffle from John Cena. The ten-knuckle shuffle, if you will. Taking down Ryback. That could be it. That could be it for Ryback. Crowd's going wild. No! John Cena's calling for the AA, the FU, the attitude adjustment. The fireman's carry and an AA to Ryback. One, two, three. And John Cena pins Ryback here on Monday Night Raw. Taking down the big guy. Proving why John Cena is our current WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
And soliciting Ryback as a little bitch.
Oh, shit. Ryback will really have to prove himself. Oh, he tried to hold hands with Ryback.
Ryback said, "I'm not about that shit, man."
I wasn't looking. I didn't realize you should have said something, Thorn. Ryback's frustration is growing after losing to John Cena. Do. Remember, Extreme Rules is only 4 weeks away. Gonna see some extreme matches. Probably Ryback versus John Cena. It's looking like it. Potentially, hopefully not, a Primetime Players versus Lucha Dragons match. But who knows, we might have to cut that match from the card. You never know. Next up, our main event. Seth Rollins versus Stone Cold Steve Austin in a false count anywhere match. Pretty insane, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
To end off our first ever Monday Night Raw. The future versus the past. False count anywhere. No disqualification. No countouts. As we see the match begin.
Seth Rollins looks focused here tonight, King. Oh, look out.
And the lockup. Who's stronger? Who do you take in this match?
I have to go with Steve Austin.
I am actually going to go Seth Rollins. I think this is his chance to prove himself. I know that for a while there, Stone Austin, not on film though, Stone Cold Steve Austin had a chance of holding your other championship, the Thorn Super Sweet Championship belt.
Oh yeah.
Which is currently held by the Big Show, who beat Stone Cold Steve Austin for the title. It was on film, it was in my first impressions for this game.
Oh.
I did that match where Big Show beat Steve Austin for the belt. environment. Seth Rollins already going for a weapon under the ring. Head-to-head.
No excuses.
What is he going for? Going for the sledgehammer. Throws it down, picks it back up. Stone Cold Steve Austin grabbing a chair. Seth Rollins, showing that they can both use weapons but don't need to. Throwing Seth Rollins in the stair. Remember, falls count anywhere as the ref follows them out. They can pin on the outside after dealing a ton of damage to each other. Punching Seth Rollins and a reversal by Rollins. Maybe trying to take on Stone Cold Steve Austin, throwing him into the table, but he's going to need to remove that Raw cover if he wants to put him through the table. Rollins, just for the third time, throwing him into the table, going to body slam him, but instead a neck breaker by Stone Cold Steve Austin. What is Austin planning here? Slamming Seth Rollins' arm down as Austin grabs the steel stairs. A good preview of what Extreme Rules could be here in 4 weeks. Maybe to see a match like this. Seth Rollins has steel chairs closing in on him. But Austin steals it back. Just a taste of what you could see at Extreme Rules. And takes down Rollins and continues to dish out the pain to Rollins, throwing down the steps. Is Austin going to go for the pin? No, he's not, as he picks Rollins up. I think he might have been going for a stunner there. But Rollins reverses it. Taking him down. What's Seth Rollins planning here? Kicking and punching Austin. These two are putting out. But a spine buster to Seth Rollins. As he picks Seth Rollins up. Throwing him into the metal pole. We could see someone injured here tonight. This could cut someone's career short. As we see Austin just beating the ever-loving shit out of Seth Rollins, taking him all the way down to the ground. Rollins fighting it but can't stay on his feet. The absolute beatdown from Austin as he goes for the pin on the outside. One. No! Rollins kicks out after a one count. That's gotta piss Austin off. And he goes for the big knee, but Rollins rolls out of the way. Drop kicking Stone Cold. Picking him up. What could he be doing here? Kicking him, trying to lay into Austin just like he laid into him, and finally hits the body slam on the outside. That's solid concrete. I don't know what Ron's planning. Think he might be going for a bell or something, but he can't. He's stuck in the corner. As Austin comes up from behind, maybe trying to run away, but can't jump the barricade. As Austin picks him up, but Rollins able to stop before he gets another move. And the body slam once again. Going for the pin. One. Two. Getting Austin with the two count. More than Austin could get on Rollins. And the slap to Stone Cold Steve Austin. Treating him like a little bitch. Someone here tonight is walking away with a loss. Steve Austin or Seth Rollins. You think it's going to be Rollins. And he breaks the cover. You think it's going either way right now, though?
Yeah, it's definitely a pretty good matchup.
Missing the punch. That could cost Steve Austin as Rollins throws him hard. Rolling him over. Could be trying to submit him on the outside, locking it in. Trying to make Stone Cold Steve Austin tap out. Could we see? No. Rollins letting him go before Steve Austin has a chance to break out. Knew he wasn't going to get Austin to tap out just yet. And the spinning neck breaker to Seth Rollins. Austin could be calling for the stunner right now. Could this be it? As we see it. And a stunner to Rollins on the outside. That's got to be it. One. Two. No, Rollins kicks out of the stunner. And that pisses Stone Cold off, immediately kneeing him in the back, going for the pin again. One, two. No, Rollins still refuses to go down. Austin can't believe it. He does not want to walk away from this very first Raw with a loss to Seth Rollins, but neither does Rollins. Rollins wants to prove himself as he knees Rollins repeatedly in the gut and to the side. And Seth Rollins going for the DDT. As we see the pinfall on Austin. One, two, but Austin kicks out. If Rollins could hit that curb stomp, that could be it for Austin, seeing as he's already at a two count. I think it really comes down to whoever can hit their finisher next, if not just a big move.
Well, out here you have to be able to.
Oh, but Austin grabs and knees him in the gut several times, taking him not to his feet, but Seth Rollins staggers back, manages to stay up, punching Austin himself, grabbing him. Nope, just keeps on punching. Now the grab, throwing him into the ring. He wants to finish this in the ring, as we see Rollins follow him inside. Back on the matting, tired of the concrete. Oh, reversing Austin's grab. We see Austin throw. I mean, we see Rollins throw Austin in the turnbuckle. Austin reverses. Oh, and the Fez press from Austin on the Seth Rollins. This could be it. This could set up another Stone Cold Stunner. No, he's going for the pin. Going to pin off the Fez press. Could he do it? One, two, three, and in the ring. Stone Cold Steve Austin pins Seth Rollins. Stone Cold walking away with the victory. Rollins walking away with the first loss. 0-1. These are the matches that mean everything because it's their first match. That was our main event. A great main event it was. First main event of Monday Night Raw. Austin's thrilled. Telling the ref to his victory. Thank you all for joining us from this Monday Night Raw. Hope you enjoyed. And we'll see you Wednesday. Not necessarily real life Wednesday, but in-game Wednesday at NXT. Except for you watching the stream, you're about to see this. We're just going to cut this out when we upload it to YouTube. I'm actually going to get a drink before we start NXT. My throat's a little dry. I've been calling some matches.
Yeah.
All night, and so I'm going to grab them and like scarf down an entire bag of Cheez-Its. Just swallow it whole. Would you like something while I'm down there?
No, but I got to pee in a second here.
Okay. As we see, we end our Monday Night Raw. We go back. Play matches. We're going to advance to the next one, which hopefully has five. As we see some rivalries down here. Got I need to fix this. I don't know why there are still divas. Edit. Participants. Where is Paige? I swore it took her out. LMNOP.
Yeah, she's not added.
And neither is him. So then why are they like, she's added for some reason? Accept changes. So now. No, and then we accept. And then Emma shouldn't still be there, right? Why?
I don't know.
Custom maybe you gotta edit superstars.
Next one. Move run two.
I'm so confused. Maybe if I go to title management. Oh, hey, we can add someone else to NXT since Emma's gone.
I don't know.
King Kong? Let's add Kakashi. Alright. Shouldn't have any divas. Nope. Just team participants. Divas should all be gone. Okay. Temporary break. Then we'll come back to NXT.
okay?
Yeah. Ah. Be starting up again soon. You know what the good thing about NXT is? Since there's only 5 matches and we have it as its own show, it still gets 3 rivalries for NXT.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So like 3 of the matches, things will actually happen.
Yeah.
At some point, I'm going to add, like, an NXT its own pay-per-view or something.
Okay.
But I'm not going to worry about that now, since we don't have much time.
Yeah.
One. Thank you. Thanks. All right. Are you ready for NXT?
Yeah.
Okay. Smudge. Welcome to NXT, our first NXT, where we begin with... Is he just... No, it's not flipping. That's the bird. And I was flipping us off. Where we begin with our very first match. Opening match is Hideo Itami versus Deadpool. Deadpool is our NXT champion. Thorne's cat is playing with our mind. He just hit it with a water bottle. Beginning match in NXT is NXT champion Deadpool versus Hideo Itami. NXT is the show where we have... the majority, if not all, our calls. We've got 3 that we made ourselves on the main roster. But all the other calls are on NXT along with your basic NXT wrestlers. Which, surprisingly, there's like 9 of or something. Not many. Not many at all.
Yeah.
So who do you think's got it in this match?
Gotta go with the current NXT champion, Deadpool.
I have to say the same thing, having seen his dominance... in the NXT tournament. I really gotta believe it's gonna be him. As we see them immediately lock up and Hideo Itami pushing Deadpool into the ring. They're equally strong. Both playing fair, both backing off when time comes, but they lock him again. Deadpool freaking out a little bit there.
And it's just gonna keep getting better as the night goes on.
As we see a headlock from Hideo Itami. Pushing him into the ropes. Drop kick to Deadpool. Hideo Itami could be looking for a shot at that NXT championship. Maybe wants to put down Deadpool here.
Ever since he came to the States.
They're shining down the road. We do have NXT matches at Extreme Rules, specifically the title matches.
An injury here from Deadpool would definitely put his title at risk. What?
You're very correct.
Power and elbow tie.
I'm looking at you while you talk.
Critical for a competitor in establishing themselves
on
the mat.
Look at me.
Here we go with Hideo Itami.
I'm actually a little disappointed in Deadpool at this match right now.
Oh.
Really getting his ass handed.
Let me tell you, if you want to see Deadpool fucking end some careers, go watch the NXT tag team tournament. That, not tag team, the NXT championship tournament I did.
Hideo Itami reversing it. Incredible.
Hideo Itami fighting back. Deadpool finally reversing.
He certainly does have a wide array of offense, King. As
Deadpool's got
before.
Great stamina, though. He's also, I believe he's superhuman. I don't actually know that much about Deadpool.
Especially
I believe you do.
Kick. I mean, that thing is lethal.
As he kicks Hideo Itami in the head. Go ahead and take him down. Deadpool could, this person came to see Itami. Deadpool,
look at that.
Fisherman suplex.
No,
Hideo Itami could put him out immediately.
Definitely turn this match around completely.
Exactly. Oh, turn it again. Then a drop kick from Deadpool. Stomping him down. Deadpool might want to put away Hideo Itami's dreams of the NXT Championship right away. Oh, and a drop kick to from Hideo Itami. Just drop kicks left and right between everyone. And a huge power bomb from Deadpool to Hideo Itami.
Kicking right here.
Kicking him in the back of the head.
Look at this.
This will see Deadpool.
That's it.
With that
he's
combination
out.
Back neck breaker. Going for the pin. One. Two.
Oh, look at
that. Oh, and the kick out. So amazing.
Like they say, Cole, timing is everything.
Hideo Itami doesn't want to go down just yet.
He's got him.
He knows this is his shot. This is the one shot he'll get. If he loses this, he may not get a shot at the NXT title.
Hideo Itami reversing it. Incredible.
Hideo Itami, regardless,
he's
is going for the drop kick.
Offense here. Yeah, that's when he's the most dangerous.
Calling for his finisher now. Maybe going for the GTS. And he does. He picks up Deadpool for the GTS. And connects it. That could be it for Deadpool.
Covers.
One. Two. Oh, but Deadpool kicks out. Both men really giving it up their all tonight. Really, pushing past barriers.
Hideo Itami.
As Hideo Itami grabs Deadpool. And then flips him over. Throwing Deadpool into the ropes.
Just toying with the competition a
little. Thorne is talking to his cat, not the audience.
Well, I mean, shit, the audience may want some cheese, but I don't have any
to avoid that.
Deadpool.
And
grabbing Hideo Itami from behind. And a tiger suplex to Hideo Itami. Could be going for the pin. That's got to be it for Hideo Itami. Deadpool goes for the pin. One, two, and Hideo Itami kicks out after two. Deadpool having none of this, very tired. Elbowing Hideo Itami in the head. Very sick of the shenanigans. Wants to put an end to it right now. Doesn't want any of it.
And Hideo
headbutting.
It.
A headbutt.
Oh,
an inverted
minute,
stunner.
Cole, what's he gonna do here?
You know, as he snapmares Deadpool and kicks him in the back of the head. Hideo Itami going for the pin. One. Two.
And he breaks
Deadpool barely kicks out of that.
To get the job done. We're looking at complete.
But we now know that Hideo gets one more good move in. He could pin the NXT champion. Deadpool picking up Hideo Itami and slamming him back down with authority. Not the shitty one.
He's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously
Deadpool stomping Hideo Itami back down. Every time Hideo Itami tries to get back up, Deadpool just puts him back down in his place. Oh, but Hideo Itami grabs him, picks him up into a power bomb. That could be it for Deadpool. That could be the one big move that puts him down. This is looking like it's it. One, two. No, Deadpool still kicks out. What is Hideo going to have to do to take down Deadpool?
There are a few better.
Runty doesn't know either. Dale throwing him into the corner. Could be setting up for that hesitation drop kick. Knocking him down. And the drop kick to Deadpool. That I think that's it. The crowd's going wild. This would be pinning the NXT champion. One, two. But he still kicks out. Deadpool never giving up. Hideo Itami can't believe it. Deadpool is NXT champion for a reason.
It starts to feel like
punching Hideo Itami, which
Deadpool is really destroying Hideo Itami's resolve over here.
And a sling blade, Hideo Itami. What is Deadpool doing? Deadpool, what are you doing? Now is not the time for that. Looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other. Deadpool setting up the table, maybe planning to put Hideo Itami through it. Doesn't want to get counted out. You gotta jump on it. Stepping back out of the ring and waiting for Hideo Itami to come out, trying to lure him over to the table. First NXT match going this far, Deadpool ruling him in, maybe not. Maybe just trying to trick him, throwing Hideo Itami off a distraction. But Hideo reverses, knocks him down to the ground. Oh, and a stomp to Deadpool.
Will somebody
Hideo's calling for the GTS. Maybe not. I don't think we're going to see anyone going through the table, but I think we're going to see a second GTS here to the NXT champion. If he gets hit with this, he's going down for sure. And there's the GTS to Deadpool. And the pin. One, two. No, that was two. Deadpool kicks out. I miscounted. Deadpool kicking out of two GTSs. Proving for sure that he is the champ of champs. He deserves to be here at NXT and the WWE as Hideo Itami goes to throw Deadpool into the corner. Momentum is on fast, by the way. This isn't even a slow momentum match. That's just how insane this opening NXT match is. Oh, Deadpool kicks him, gets on the top rope, jumps, and the flying crossbody to Hideo Itami. The crowd goes fucking nuts. Rolling Hideo Itami over. And stomping on the arm of Hideo Itami. You know what? It's good that this opening match is going long, because this is only a four-match NXT. One of the matches is a Divas match. Oh, and the zigzag from Dolphul! Dragging Hideo Itami's corpse to the center of the ring. Going for the pin. One, two, three! And Deadpool pins Hideo Itami. Proving himself as the dominant champion.
And here's some highlights from the matchup.
How did you feel about that opening match?
Oh, that was a great opening match, but I expected no less from NXT.
Much better than the opening match in WWE. Maybe looking at the boy. That was a Deadpool winning it. Doesn't have his NXT title for some reason. I know I gave it to him. Didn't decide to come out with it. Didn't want Hideo stealing it. Deadpool trusts no one. These guys look like a couple of hosses going at it in there. As we exit the match. Hideo Itami has been named the new number one contender after a strong showing in the non-title match against champion Deadpool.
Whoa.
Fair enough, that was a very good showing.
Yeah.
Even though Deadpool did kill the shit of him, he did put up a good fight. Anyone else, I think, would have lost to that second GTS, if not the first one. But we don't do Divas matches because there's just not enough Divas in this game. There's like 18 Divas in this entire game. Which they told it as being most in any WWE game, even if it's true, that's really sad.
Yeah.
So match number three is Paige versus Summer Rae. We're not going to do it. Next up is Finn Balor versus the Rare Pepe. Nothing to this fight, just showing off Finn Balor and Rare Pepe. Both going in their debuts. Would you like to say a few words about this match? Who do you favorite going into this match?
Rare Pepe.
The Rare Pepe? Do you want him to win or do you think he'll win?
I do not think he'll win. But I do definitely want him to.
Alright. I think I'm good either way. I think this is a very down-the-middle match. Could go either way. Let's just call it for what it is. An all-out brawl. This match is not an impressive display. Finn Balor starting off strong, throwing down the Rare Pepe. And a huge knee drop to the Rare Pepe's face.
Already he feels so strong.
Is this your favorite wrestler, Thor?
No.
Is Baron Corbin your favorite?
No.
Steve Austin?
No.
Big Show?
No.
Who?
I don't think I have a favorite. Having come up through the dojos
in Japan, Finn Balor. Is he in your top wrestlers?
No. Not everybody possesses. And you'd have to credit
Finn Balor's time in Japan for his extensive knowledge. Finn Balor throwing Rare Pepe aside, taunting him, looking into the face of the Rare Pepe, saying shenanigans to him. Well, we're on the move here. Kicking him absolute victimizing Rare Pepe. JBL's hat falls to the ground. This match could be over sooner. I think the Rare Pepe is in big trouble here. Oh, starting to make a comeback. Get the blood flowing back in your body and strategize. Finn Balor reverses it. Your next form of attack will be. Pick him up. Oh, and the knee to the face. Outside the ring is survival. As Finn Balor goes in not to get counted out. Ref at a count of what looks like six.
I think so.
Getting back to Balor's time.
Rey Pepe running away wisely.
A huge star over there, as well as in the United
Goes to taunt. But Finn Balor grabs him, throws him in the corner. Kick him in the back and slamming him down. Just stay down, Rey Pepe. Could Finn Balor be going for the coup de grace? Going to the top rope. No, Rey Pepe gets up. That was a foolish move, Rey Pepe. Finn Balor pushes Rey Pepe off. Oh, and a swinging neckbreaker. Running neckbreaker, whatever you want to call it. And the snapmare, this is where Rey Pepe could get some offense in, putting Finn Balor in a headlock.
If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly, real fast. This can be dangerous.
Finn Balor, one of the better human wrestlers here on NXT.
Finn Balor is a global phenomenon.
Rey Pepe, not much to say about him. He's not common, I'll tell you that much.
Feels bad.
Finn Balor setting up the hesitation drop kick. Getting him in the corner, stopping him down. Oh! Rey Pepe drop kicks Finn Balor. This is where the tides turn and Rey Pepe makes a huge comeback. The upset could be real here tonight. No, Finn Balor picks him up and drops him down with a gut buster. Running into the ropes, could we see the coup de grace here? Is Finn Balor going to go for it? He's calling for the coup de grace. And that's it. The coup de grace to Rey Pepe. That's got to be it. 1, 2, 3. Finn Balor defeats Rey Pepe on their debut match here at NXT.
We got a couple of highlights here. Let's check out.
How do you feel, Thorn?
Feels bad.
Here's your winner. Finn Balor celebrates, maybe wants to earn himself a possible shot at that NXT championship.
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me know, Finn.
And that'll do it here for this one-on-one match. I hope you enjoyed it as much as this live crowd appears to have enjoyed it.
Now, moving on to the third match of NXT. We're halfway through the night. We've had a very long match, a fairly short match. But the great thing about NXT is that with only 5 matches and 3 rivalries, pretty much 3 out of 5 matches, 3/5 of the show is going to be all story, all plot progression. We've got Hideo Itami as the number 1 contender. We're skipping this Divas match. I don't remember how. It's square, page 1, doesn't matter. Next up, we've got Batman versus Nemesis from Resident Evil. Going up against each other. Batman, the Dark Knight. Nemesis, Spooky,
Spooks.
What do you have to say about this match, Thorn?
Hope it's longer than the last one.
Hope it's not a complete and total beatdown. Good versus evil. Hero versus villain. You know, classic storytelling. Batman wants to put an end to Nemesis's reign of zombie evil. Zombievil, if you will. Long loading time, WWE. Long loading times.
It's at the very end there. Come on.
That being said, who's your money on in this fight, Thor?
I gotta go with Nemesis.
I'm actually going Batman. I've seen Batman. If any of you watched my other WWE 2K16 videos, Batman has won both of the Royal Rumbles that I've held.
Oh.
I then put him against 6 different people in Hell in a Cell. He snapped all of their necks with no mercy. So I think I'm going to have to go with Batman here. Batman's really proven himself a dominant force.
Man, Batman's really just going at it.
Batman was not in the NXT Championship Tournament. I specifically left him and Venom out of the tournament as I felt like they would be too overpowered, too one-sided in the tournament. Wait, no, Batman was in the tournament. He was against Luigi, but Luigi escaped from the steel cage before Batman could. Because he didn't have to beat Batman, he just had to run away from Batman. I forgot about that. Batman's clearly pissed about that outcome, too. Taking out all of his rage on Nemesis. Wanted to be defeated by someone like Luigi, who would then not even win the NXT Championship. Nemesis trying to make a comeback, realizes he can't let Batman get this much momentum going. Gotta throw him out, give himself a breather. Nemesis running to the outside. Maybe trying to lure Batman over.
You have to wonder what's going through.
Nemesis trying to catch his breath after that huge beat down from Nemesis.
He's making a statement.
I mean, Nemesis trying to catch his breath after that huge beat out from Batman. Batman reverses it. Oh, but Nemesis press from Nemesis. Them fighting on the outside. There is DQ. These men will be counted out. Isn't that right, ref?
That's right, referee. All right.
There we go. This is first thing I thought maybe was a DQ, no DQ, and I missed it. Nemesis running back into the ring as Batman gets back up. Nemesis trying to finally mount some offense, but Batman stops on him. Wade Barrett. The bat is throwing me off. Oh, and the big punch from Nemesis to stop Batman from getting him. So I've honestly never seen Batman lose a match. This includes Royal Rumbles. Could this be Batman's first ever loss, his first official match here at NXT? What do you think?
Uh-oh. Well, the ties sure have turned towards Nemesis, so...
Nemesis planning to use this his wrestling abilities to found the new Umbrella Corporation. Start a zombie apocalypse all over again. We all remember the first one. As he picks up Batman, could be going for a DDT here. Oh! And a huge reversal from Batman. But Nemesis knees Batman in the junk and kicks him down. That amazing move by Batman was met only by a counter. Nemesis is ready. Nemesis underrated Batman at the beginning of this match, and he's not going to do it again. Nemesis is building himself up as a true villain here, needing to take down the Dark Knight Batman, take control of Gotham City, and the big leg drop to Batman's head. As Nemesis rolls him over, what's he planning here? Oh, and a knee drop. As he picks Batman up, grabbing him, and a DDT to Batman. This could be it. Batman could go down here. One. Two! Batman kicks out at the last second. Nemesis can't believe it. That's Nemesis' great DDT. Something he uses quite often. Oh, Batman grabs him. Where's Batman gonna take him? To the corner, to the ropes, to the ropes. Batman, what are you planning? Throws Nemesis over to the other side of the ropes. Going to the outside. Batman, don't do it! Batman showing him a DDT of his own! Oh, onto the outside. Crushing Nemesis' skull. Nemesis' skull. Oh, and then just punching him. Oh, and then the slam to the concrete outside. 4:20 blaze at PM, everyone. As Batman punches Nemesis and slaps him. Thorn Dog runs in with a water bottle. I think Nemesis could be in trouble here after that huge DDT to the apron. Batman picking him up and throwing him down with a big suplex.
This might be a case of
kicking Nemesis in the back of the head. Just end it, Batman. Just end it. Oh, and the heavy strike to the back of Nemesis's head. What is Batman planning here? Picking him up. Setting him up for the Batbuster. The back alley buster where Batman's parents were shot. The back alley buster to Nemesis. That's gotta be it. The crowd goes wild. One, two. Oh, and Nemesis kicks out. The insanity of these matches here tonight. Here on NXT. How have you been enjoying NXT, Thorn?
Better than Raw.
Raw went on a bit too long without too much going on. Oh, Nemesis picking him up. What's he gonna do to Batman? Oh, and the slam! That could be it for Batman. One, two, no, Batman kicks out. Nemesis cannot believe at all. What will Nemesis have to do to put Batman away? Nothing, because Batman's about to put Nemesis away. Batman picks him up. Doing something. Oh, and the huge knee to Nemesis. Going for the kick to his feetsies as well. dragging Nemesis to the middle of the ring, gonna pin it off that huge knee. One, two, three, and Batman defeats Nemesis in his premiere match. Quite the great debuts from everyone here except for the rare Pepe. They've all really shown what they're made of. And now, Thorne, are you ready for our main event tonight?
I can't believe what we just saw.
What is it?
We're about to find out. As Batman cheers his victory, the true hero of Gotham.
It was simply a case of one guy determined to prove his...
Fist bump, Batman. Fist bump. And now, we move on to the main event. It's very curious what the main event could be, seeing as how our champion was in the opening match of NXT. Could it be the tag team champions, Sans and Papyrus? Potentially. Blech. But the main event of Raw tonight will be Lord Voldemort versus Nicolas Cage as Shrek to end off NXT. Here we go. Thoughts on the main event, Thorin?
I think this is going to be a great turnout.
Who is your money on?
I gotta say, it's on Voldemort.
Now, I, as the main commentator, like to call things down the middle, but I have to say I am a big fan of Nicolas Cage dressed as Shrek. His head's cut off a little bit in the loading thing there. Just a wee bit. If you enjoyed this NXT, leave a lick below for Nicolas Cage dressed as Shrek. As we begin our main event, if you can hear thuds, Thorne's dog has a pet. Nicolas Cage grabs Voldemort and immediately tries to snap his elbow like a twig. Nicolas Cage is not a very large man, but his Shrek costume is. Oh, Voldemort reverses that big throw. Voldemort's been through hell. He's been in Hell in a Cell with Batman before. As he does a huge standing suplex to Nicolas Cage. Voldemort punching him. Cage throws Voldemort into the corner and headbutts him. What else could he be planning here? Oh, just throwing him hard into the turnbuckle, into a German suplex! People are pretty burnt out from the last few matches. They're not super into it. They're more just watching in awe as these events take place. And a headlock on the Lord Voldemort.
Oh, Nicolas Cage breaks his own ribs.
It's a costume, Thorn, don't worry. Oh, and the slap from Voldemort. Oh, and the headbutt from Nicolas Cage. Stopping any kind of momentum Voldemort was trying to build. But Voldemort, he's still trying to fight back, grabbing him. What's he gonna do? Going for a DDT, a suplex. Oh, an arm wrench. Voldemort could mount the comeback here. Picking him up and slamming down Nicolas Cage. As we see him get lifted back up by the horns. Oh, but a back body toss by Nicolas Cage to Voldemort. Punching him repeatedly in the head. An absolute beatdown. Nicolas Cage snuggying Voldemort with his huge ogre muscles. Throwing Voldemort back down. God, no matter who wins this, I just hope Voldemort gets out of here uninjured. As we see Voldemort try to throw Nicolas Cage to the outside and succeeding. Going there, this will be his chance to weaken him, have to use that concrete to his advantage, trying to shatter the knee of Nicolas Cage on the concrete outside. This is a DQ match. They will be counted out and disqualified if weapons are used. That being said, for some reason, going through the announce table is perfectly legal as Nicolas Cage is thrown into the stairs. Crawling up to his feet. Oh, but he stops him in another headbutt to Voldemort all the way to the ground. Nicolas Cage running in before he's counted out as Voldemort barely makes his way back to feet. We're at a six count as Voldemort makes his way back into the ring. Who's going to get the advantage first? Voldemort grabs him. No, spins him around again, trying to get him all dazed, confused. And then a neck breaker, just an elbow neck breaker or something there to Nicolas Cage.
Look at this.
As he punches Cage back down. Picking up No, rolling him over, and another punch to Nicolas Cage, just having to go with ruthless aggression to take him out, trying to confuse him. What's he gonna do here? And a snapmare to Nicolas Cage, grabbing him in a headlock, trying to choke out. This is his swamp, but he might die here tonight. Nicolas Cage is already hot and sweaty in that outfit. This has got to be hard for him to breathe through.
Can happen in WWE.
That's something. Voldemort choking him. He's real and having trouble. Could we see Nicolas Cage tap out here?
Yeah, absolutely anything can happen in the WWE.
Okay, Nicolas Cage didn't tap out.
To the limit here.
Oh, but Voldemort slamming him down face first. That could be it for Nicolas Cage. Voldemort picks him back up. Oh, and he reverses the chop. Nicolas Cage, oh, but reverses the elbow. And a kick. By Voldemort onto Nicolas Cage, going for the pin. One, two. No, Nicolas Cage kicks out the last second. Ref almost slapping Nicolas Cage in the face with those counts. I think the ref is disgusted by this creature. If you can hear grunting fringe bulldogs in the background, there's a battle going on. As we see Voldemort slam Nicolas Cage back down a second time, picking him up, going for that chop again maybe. Oh, and the big chop from Voldemort. I think that's got to be it for Nicolas Cage. And the pin. One, two. Oh, and Nicolas Cage kicks out immediately after the two count. And the big kick to the back by Voldemort. What is he going to have to do to take down Nicolas Cage? He's going to have to put him through a table. This was teased in the main event of Raw. Will it happen in the main event of NXT? As we see him throw Nicolas Cage into the table. What's he going to do? He's going for it. Nicolas Cage is going to be put through a table by Voldemort. Oh my god, Voldemort tombstoning Nicolas Cage through the table. I don't know why JBL and Michael Cole are in NXT, but that's besides the point. And Nicolas Cage no-sells it, throwing Voldemort into the ring. He's unaffected by that table shot. Nicolas Cage is calling for it. Putting him through that table only angered the beast. He picks him up. Oh, this is my swamp. Voldemort's gone down. That's it. It's all ogre now. One, two. But Voldemort kicks out. It's never ogre. It's never ogre. An insane main event here tonight at NXT. As Voldemort hits the neck breaker on Nicolas Cage. And goes for the pin. One, two. And that's still not enough to take down Nicolas Cage. Voldemort's going to have to put forth a lot more effort. Oh, grabs him. Oh, but Voldemort reverses what looked like a German suplex. And grabbing him again. Pick him up, reverses the exploder suplex this time. Voldemort really putting up a fight here, going for the pin once again. One, two, three, and finally Voldemort puts down Nicolas Cage as Shrek. Quite the insane main event we had here tonight. Quite insane indeed. How did you feel about that main event, Thorn?
That was quite the main event for NXT.
Let's see the table shot once again.
Check out what happened during this match.
Which apparently only tickled and infuriated Nicolas Cage. Voldemort deserved to win after this here. I can't believe how easily. I think his head bounced off a monitor there as well.
Match of the year.
And then I believe this was the ending of the match. Right here, this neck breaker, this elbow neck breaker, pinning him. One, two, three.
You want to talk about
thank you all for joining us. That was not the ending move. Thank you all for joining us here at the first ever NXT where we end up with Voldemort beating Nicolas Cage in a Shrek outfit after putting him through a table head first.
Will this become the main rivalry of NXT?
I wouldn't be surprised. And thus ends it. Thank you for watching NXT! So, it is 4:32 now. Do you want to try and do the four SmackDown matches before Debbie shows up?
I think we got a little less than 30 minutes. You think we can do that in less than 30 minutes?
Do you think so?
I don't know.
I think so.
Alright, we can try.
Let's go for it. Advance. Yes. Good, no female matches in this. Alright. Welcome to the first ever Friday Night SmackDown, where we're clearly beginning with top-notch competition as we begin with R-Truth versus Jack Swagger to open WWE Friday Night SmackDown. What are your thoughts, Thorne?
This is quite the opening match.
First ever Friday Night SmackDown opening strong. Is this even possible to call?
No.
I'm here once again with my co-commentator, Thorne. And thank you for being part of what promises to you. Had to pick tonight. Someone, who would you pick? My money is on the real American, Jack Swagger.
Jack Swagger is quite the amazing, but maybe R-Truth can pull something out of his pants and turn this around. Just like he turned around right now.
So you're going with...
I still have to side with Jack Swagger, though.
Alright. R-Truth got some levitating hair there as he fights back. No one's backing down here. One of these two men vying maybe to impress each other. Not impress each other. Impress the WWE universe. Impress Vince McMahon. Maybe try to earn a shot at the title. Maybe the recognized character championship. Possibly Big Pimpin'. Oh, and a huge German suplex from Jack Swagger with that kind of moves, maybe even the World Heavyweight Championship. Who knows, the winner here tonight might become the number one contender to the Big Pimpin' Championship. Jack Swagger's outstanding amateur back. Thorne still has to decide who will face the Big Show at Extreme Rules for his Thorne Super Sweet Championship belt.
Right now, I'm keeping my eyes open for all these impressive wrestlers so far.
Such as R-Truth and Jack Swagger. When he sees an opening, he takes it immediately, and then... R-Truth going in for the headbutt.
Sickening, I know.
I hope that got picked up. R-Truth punching away at Jack Swagger.
And Jack Swagger just tanking a beating. Even though I don't think R-Truth is trying to pin him absolutely.
Oh, and the face plant by R-Truth. This could be it for Jack. No, Jack Swagger reverses. The real American setting him up. Oh, but R-Truth with the backflip. As he goes, and the fisherman suplex to R-Truth. And stomping the head of R-Truth repeatedly. It's like cats and dogs here in the middle of the ring. He's the guy that's opponent, and what's he going for here? Oh, and a back-to-belly suplex. Smudge climbs inside a cabinet. The battle rages on. Truly, SmackDown is where war takes place. R-Truth going for three big elbows. No, but Jack Swagger gets out. Could reverse this into the ankle lock. No, R-Truth manages to get back to his feet before that happens. And a belly-to-belly suplex from Jack Swagger, becoming the new suplex king. Look out! As we see Jack Swagger pushing him down, just twisting that leg of Truth. Could we be seeing a Swagger Bomb soon? Oh, and taking out the leg of R-Truth. As we see him pick up, he's going to pin. Now it's time. Oh, and that front face flip to R-Truth. Jack Swagger's calling for it. Either the Swagger Bomb or the ankle lock. I'm not sure which one. Oh, this spells trouble right He's here. Calling for the Swagger Bomb. There should be the gun. Oh, taking down R-Truth. This could be it. One, two, three. An intense match to begin Friday Night Smackdown. Jack Swagger winning his first ever match against R-Truth. Truly a match that will go down in the records book as Jack Swagger's magnum opus. Let's take a look back. How do you feel about this match, Thorin?
It's incredible to believe that R-Truth could lose such an easy match.
You calling Jack Swagger easy?
Yep, calling him a little bitch.
Oh shit, them's fighting words. Maybe Jack Swagger will have to face Big Show at Extreme Rules. Fucking Hell in a Cell. We the people. Tables match. So SmackDown only has four matches. It's a miniature show. It's where we show off the people that didn't get a chance to get shown off on Raw. Just some good, fun wrestling matches. Not much story unless stories get built on SmackDown. Because me and Thorn have to choose our rivalries for the Big Pimpin' Championship and Thorn's Super Sweet Championship. And maybe we'll decide here at the next great match, Damian Sandow versus Fandango. Are you... What? What were you saying, Thorn?
Mizdow.
It's not Mizdow.
It's not Mizdow.
It's not Mizdow. It's fucking dumb they made that his default name in this game. He wasn't, like, dead serious. That gimmick was over when they released this game. Like, that entire rivalry was over when they released this game. Yeah, who would have ever thought... Fandango versus Damian Mizdow. What are your thoughts? What are your thoughts here, Thorn?
I'm hoping Fandango pulls out some fancy dance moves.
All right, who's your money on this? Who do you think's gonna win their debut match, Damian Sandow or Fandango?
I gotta say, Sandow's probably gonna be the one looking good in this match, but so far he's getting his ass kicked by a guy in shiny pants.
Now I'm a fan of both these wrestlers. Oh God, he's got fucking Miz tights on. This is why I waste a call slot to download a social outcast tight support. Damn it, I have Curtis Axel, not Curtis Axel, I have Heath Slater in a different faction in this universe mode, so I replaced him with Damian Sandow in the social outcasts. Thorn's dog is vomiting in its mouth at the thought of Damian Mizdow losing to Fandango. Oh, Fandango going for that spinning kick. I think that might have been his signature, but Damian Sandow reverses it. Oh, and the big face buster as Fandango rolls out of the ring and gets back in to get out. But Damian Sandow grabs him yet again, picking him up. Oh, and the backbreaker. This is Sandow's chance for revenge. This is his chance to make a comeback as we see him hit another backbreaker. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Fandango kicks.
Almost, Trez. Almost.
Almost three on the mighty Fandango, who won his real-life debut match at WrestleMania against Chris Jericho. You can never forget that. Damian Sandow throwing Fandango over the ropes. Oh! And hitting Miz's signature move. I don't know what it's called, though, but we'll call it the Sandow Plunge. Damian Sandow shall run with his best. Oh! And the reality check from Damian Sandow. Going for the pin on Fandango. One, two. Oh, but Fandango kicks out immediately after the two count. Getting up just as quickly. Grabbing Sandow. Looking for a suplex. Oh, and a fancy suplex at that. What is Fandango planning? Can Fandango take out Damian Sandow? Possibly.
Possibly.
It's a good chance. And the snapmare to Damian Sandow. As we see them get in a headlock, trying to choke out Damian Sandow. end his dreams of an undefeated streak right here. Either of these men could be the next Rusev, going undefeated for a year.
But will Fandango share his gift of dance?
Fandango thrown into the corner as Sandow hits the Sandow plug again. And dogs freak out. Dogs begin screaming. We might have to pause the match, for they have gone insane. Pure insanity. Fandango just in the match. End now. Now we have to pause the match. People are in the house. I'm going to kill the mic for a second. Russian leg sweep on Fandango. Going for the pin. This could be it. One. No, he kicks out one. Damian Sandow will not stay down. Sandow will not stand down. As Damian Sandow goes, grabs him, throws him into the ropes. Throwing him to the outside of the ropes. To this outside of the ring. People are talking, please ignore. And then a crossbody from Fandango. As we see Fandango grab him. Throwing him into the ropes. Throwing him outside again for some reason. And a punch from Damian Sandow. Going in. And the reality check from Damian Sandow once again. Going for the pin. This could be it. One, two, three,
and he lived to fight again.
What?
You know, it's hard to believe.
Nah, ref, that was three. Damian Sandow screwed out of the win from Fandango by a dirty ref. Punches.
Oh, no. Just at the sight of him. The skull-crushing finale is going to end it.
And the skull-crushing finale busting open Fandango. One, two, three. And Sandow is your winner. Now for a temporary break from
Schmerker.
Because there are people in the house talking very loudly.
Well, I don't know how you can pick. And here's just some of the this. This was a.
Here's your winner, Damian.
Now that's an eye-opening victory.
Man, when you get a one-on-one match like that, you hate to see one of them come up short. But